This project I made is Fridge Calendar. I made this to easily share the events of family members. Maybe only me and my wife will update it. And my kids are still too young, so they will just check it. This updates the screen by fetching my Google Calendar data. Does it look similar to the screen on my iPhone on the right? It is the same because it draws the screen by fetching the events from my calendars through the Google Calendar API. As you can see, the device is an e-paper and battery-powered device. I bought the frame from Amazon. Since I don't have a 3D printer yet, I just cut up an existing picture frame and made it, so the size is a little off. This is very simple and intuitive. This is what I always wanted. Especially since this device does not have a touch screen, all control is done through the Google Calendar app. I don't know if this is good or bad, but I made it so that the events are drawn one by one. It looked nicer when they were updated one by one than when the entire screen was drawn at once. This is much slower than drawing the entire screen at once, but I like this feeling, so I made it this way. There are always many events, and it is not easy to express them all in a given space, so I made upcoming events. Display information about up to 6 events from today's date on the screen. This allows you to get detailed information about upcoming events. I'm going to show you how to update this Fridge Calendar via the Google Calendar app. In the actual code, I'm setting the screen to update once a day at 0:30. Right now, I have set it to update the screen once every minute to show you the entire screen update. Let's add a new event on my phone. I will write the title event test and change the calendar to my name of the calendar. Then enter the description. In the upcoming event, the description is made to be displayed up to 4 lines. Okay, my new event has been added. My new events are on the 17th and 18th back-to-back. Now wait a moment, it'll wake up from 1 minute hibernation and do the work again. Let's see if there is a new event. You will see my name on the 17th and 18th. This allowed the screen to be updated because it had received the latest data from the server. You can also check the added event information along with the date in the upcoming event. Yeah, this is what it is. This is my Fridge Calendar based on ePaper. In this video, I will briefly show you how I did it. So let's take a quick look at how this project is structured and how it works. The source code link for this project can be found in the video description below. As you can see, it is divided into 4 major components. You can see ePaper, Wi-Fi, local time, and Google Calendar. The ePaper used in this project is a 9.7-inch 1200 by 825 150 PPI product. I need a large display to see the entire schedule for this month. Also, the board used to drive this was EPDIY version 7. This board helps to easily connect many ePaper displays and it enables to update the screen effectively using the EPDIY library. This can also be used in AirVisual projects, so it is very effective hardware and library for ePaper projects. Please check the previous calendar demo for this. A Wi-Fi connection is absolutely necessary because without it, it is impossible to get data via Google's Calendar API. It is also important to get the local time. You need to have this month, today's date, and current local time information to get a certain range of events and you can minimize battery usage by hibernating until the next wake-up time. I think the most important part of this project is the use of the Google Calendar API. In order to use the API, a OAuth2 authentication is required first, which is not so easy in a microcontroller environment. If you are developing a mobile application, you can easily re-log in through a web browser. However, since MCU does not have that freedom, you need to put all the necessary information in advance and store the dynamically updated information inside the system. This is the workflow for my application. I get some data via NVS. This is perfect for storing updated the new access token as it is not erased by labeling like EEPROM. If this is the first time it is running, it will show a loading screen. Here, you can check the current status at each stage while the system updates the necessary information. After connecting to Wi-Fi, you will get the current local time. After that, you can request the desired data using HTTP POST method through Google API. First, you request the event information using access token. If the access token is no longer available, you have to use a refresh token to get a new access token and then use it again to get the event information. You can update the screen with the event information you got this way. After that, you hibernate the system until 0:30 the next day. This is the overall workflow of this fridge calendar. For more details, you can refer to my project GitHub page. Finally, let me talk about the hardware configuration. This is very simple. Since the EPDIY board already takes care of everything related to the ePaper, I was able to focus on developing the application. I just connected the battery connector, did not modify the hardware, and used it as is. Right now, I cannot get the information about the connected battery, and the function to update the screen partially is missing. I plan to update this project more if I get a large screen color ePaper display. I think using color would allow for more effective display and communication of information. Alright, that's all for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.